Good morning, all of you. Today we are starting chapter 12, exponent and power, exercise 12.2. The first question, it says that explain the following number in the standard form. Now, what is standard form? In standard form, we are given with the larger number and we have to convert the number to the simplest form, and that is known as the standard form. Here I have given a larger number. First, what I will do, I have to convert this larger number into the simplest form, and then simplest form will be known as the standard form of this number. So this is given in the usual form and we have to convert it into the standard form. So see, here I am having the decimal placed here. So what I want to do, I want to place this decimal. Suppose I want to place it here. So how many digits I will move this decimal. So let's start. I'm moving the decimal with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if I move this digit, if I move this decimal from year to year, how many digits I have moved? I have moved till 12. So I can write down this as 8.5 upon 10 to the power 12. Okay, if I move this decimal from year to year, how many digits I have moved? I have moved 12 digits, and I can write down this as 8.5 divided by 10 to the power 12. Now you know that if I am given with a negative exponent, how I will convert this in the positive one? I can write down this as 1 upon a to the power m. This laws of exponent you have studied before. Similarly, if I am given with this term, I can convert it in the vice versa also. So this is in the form of 1 upon a to the power m. So this is in the form of 1 upon a to the power of m. So I can write down this as 8.5 into 10 to the power minus 12. I am given with this form, so I am converting in this form. So this is the standard form. Similarly, in the second question, here I am having the decimal. I want to place this decimal here. So let's check how many digits we move the decimal. So let's start this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I will place this decimal after 9.42. So I can write down this as 9.42 to the power. How many digits we have moved? We have moved 12. So this will be 10 to the power 12. Again, this laws of exponent property you have learned. This is in the form of 1 upon a to the power m. So how can I write down this as? I can write down this as a to the power minus m by this property. So similarly, how I can write down this number as 9.42 into 10 to the power minus 12. This is the answer in the standard form. Similarly, in the second question here, it is given as explain the following number in the usual form. Now this number is in the standard form, and again we have to convert this number in the usual form. Like here it was given in the usual form, we have converted the number in the standard form. Similarly, here it is given in the standard form, usual form, we will convert this number in the usual form. So the first step, I am going to write this. Here it is given 3.02, and I know before only I told you a to the power minus m, this is the negative exponent. Now I will convert this in the positive, so upon 1 upon a to the power m. Similarly, here I can write down this as 1 upon 10 to the power 6. So it will become like 3.02 upon 10 to the power 6. So how many digits I have to move further from here? Don't count it from here. Count it from here. Okay, so how many digits you will move? So I'm writing 3. How many digits you have to move? You have to move 6 digits. So count this. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 digits you will move. Okay, and this again write down this point, and this 0, 2 will be written as the same. But remember, sometimes the students, they commit mistake. They write down this also, and after this, they start counting. Okay, this point we have removed now. Because of this point, I have added here this zeros. Okay, so many times the student they get confused, and what they do, they write down this both the number first, and after that they start counting. Don't do like this. After the decimal, the number which is given, you write down that number, and after that add number of zeros which is given in the power, and then at the last write down the remaining number here. So this is in the usual form. So the answer is 0.00003 02 is in the usual form. This is question number 4. In this question it says that in the stack there are 5 books, each of thickness 20 mm. Means in a stack, suppose this is a stack, there are 5 books. 5 books, suppose I am making 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are 5 books. Okay? And each of the thickness is how many? 20 mm. Means each of the thickness of this book is how much? 20 mm. And 5 paper sheets each of thickness 0.016 mm. Similarly, 5 paper sheets are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? First, 5 books are there. Each book thickness is how many? 20 mm. Similarly, 5 paper sheets are there. And after 5 paper sheets, each of the paper thickness is how much? 0.016 mm. What is the total thickness of the stack? You have to find out the total thickness of the stack. So write down. So let's start. I will write down with this thickness of one book. What is given? Thickness of one book is how much? 20 mm. Okay. Similarly, this was for one book. So for 5 books, how much? 5 book is, thickness of 5 book will be 20 into 5, that is 5 2s are 10, and this is 100 mm. So thickness of 5 book is 100 mm. Similarly, thickness of one paper sheet, thickness of one paper sheet, it is given 0.016. How much it is given? 0.016. Okay. Similarly, how many paper sheets are there? There are 5 paper sheets. So, thickness of 5 paper sheets, it will be 0.016 into 5. So, when you will multiply this, you will get 0.08. mm. Okay, now in this last question, what it is asking, what is the total thickness of this stack? We have to find out the total thickness. So for total thickness, is equal to, if I will add thickness of books plus thickness of paper sheets, so I will get the total thickness. So I am adding thickness of book plus thickness of paper sheets. So what is the thickness of book total? 100 plus of paper sheet, what it is given? 0.08. okay, now add this, what you will get? 100.00, and after this you will add 0.08. On adding, you will get 80.001. Okay. Now, what you have to do, the total thickness here you are getting is 100.08 mm. This is also the correct answer, but I am converting this into the standard form. And you know, on converting it into the standard form, I can write down this as, if I move this digit like 1.008, so if I shift this decimal 1, 2 places of decimal, so I can write down this as 1.0008 into 10 to the power 2. So this is the standard form.